Greetings. I'm Dr. Vasavi Acharya, an entrepreneur and co-founder of Local Business Network. And today we are doing another episode of Her Story, which is dedicated to the woman of Northeast on the occasion of International Women's Day. And today we are joined by Mayfereen. Mayfereen has been working, she has her own NGO and she's been working in the interiors of Meghalaya and has been doing incredible work. And her NGO is known by the name GRASSROOT, and she's the founder and head of that. So welcome, Mayfereen, welcome on board. Tell us about your journey.
The reason why we started GRASSROOT was because we wanted to do something which is rights-based other than welfare. Because we realized that empowering people, number one, to be independent, number two, to understand and know their rights, are the two main important factors that GRASSROOT started on its own. And it was started actually over a cup of tea with a couple of good friends when we discussed about what we want to do for the state of Meghalaya, because we believe very much in the state of Meghalaya that it can do so much better than it was, I would say, in 2007 when we started, and it still is doing better, and we can do much more than what we planned in 2007. And that's when we came up with a GRASSROOT as empowering communities to work for their rights and also be responsible for the people's rights.
Oh, that's so lovely. And so basically, how do you, what are the different aspects your NGO is touching upon, you know, while you are in the process of empowerment? So what exactly do you do?
So we work from an indigenous and gender lens, always. So when we work with different communities in the rural areas of the state of Meghalaya, we work, like I mentioned, indigenous and gender lens, whereby we first enter from an entry point of livelihood. So that is why when we talk about livelihood, it's not just about giving them the capacity, you know, to enable them to do something. It can be tailoring, it can be crafts, it can be loom, it can be food processing, etc. But more so, we add on the entrepreneurial skills in which they can also do something on their own. It can be as a startup, it can be maybe as business enterprise, it can be as a cooperative. We are doing this because we believe very much and very strongly that the rural areas of Meghalaya, you know, are a very rich areas, in a sense that we can tap resources, build an entrepreneurial enterprise from the resources that we have, and hopefully, and I prayerfully also say this, that we can also reduce unemployment and rural migration to urban in search of their livelihood options or opportunities, because the opportunities that is available in the rural areas are much more than what is available in the urban areas.
Absolutely, that's so rightly said, because there's a lot of migration from the rural to the urban, mm-hmm. and that migration needs to be stopped because there's a lot of untapped resources, true. Untapped potential in the rural areas. So in this journey, like you said that you're empowering them, you're making, you know, helping them become entrepreneurs, startups. So do you have you taken any initiative through which they can, you know, showcase whatever they're producing, or showcase their, you know, things that they are actually manufacturing and stuff? So any step towards that, Mayfereen?
Yes, it was in 2019 when I and my business partner, you know, we brainstorm on the idea of the lack of market. You know, whenever we speak or discuss with rural communities, they have the skills, they have the capacities, but the market is always not there. So my business partner and I started this, I would say, an online portal called Mati in Khasi, which means footprints. So the footprints of our forefathers, for example, footprints of, you know, the different traditional skills that we have. So we built on these traditional skills and built on the online market portal for these traditional, I would say, handicrafts or looms to be showcased to the world.
That's so wonderful, because again, like you said, the rural folks, basically, they're very, very talented. They are, they can really come up with the best, but again, there is a gap, you know, from what you are manufacturing or what you're making and how you are actually, you know, giving it to the market. So I think you're filling up that gap. You are acting as your platform would be acting as a bridge, you know, to lessen that gap. So Mayfereen, yes. In this journey, when you started, like, What do you think, like, because I know I'm from the Northeast, we know we have a lot of locational disadvantages, we have, you know, certain other disadvantages. So what do you think are the three blessings in spite of, you know, our struggles in this journey?
One is the abundant resources that we have, and number two is we have the community feeling of, you know, what we would call in the social work term, the we factor. So we always have, we may have failed, for example, as entrepreneurs, but we have the community who will always back us up in terms of, you know, supporting us with our endeavors, small or big endeavors. And the three blessing is, you know, having, I would say, a good team to work with. When I say a good team, not necessarily at the organizational level, but a good team, the rural artisans are a good team. You know, the rural small scale entrepreneurs are a good team. So having those, I think we can really move forward as not just as blessings, Dr. Vasavi, but also as opportunities that can bring Northeast into the front. Because I believe that if Northeast is showcased as much as we showcase other states of the country, I'm very sure a lot of examples from Northeast will be followed throughout the country.
And these are the blessings that you have talked about. And what were the major challenges? Like we already said, we have some disadvantages, but what actually were some challenges that you think had, you know, kind of obstructed in this journey, or kind of, you know, stayed as hurdles in this journey?
So one of the challenges, as you have mentioned, the location, which is the logistics. If we're talking business, so the logistics is very challenging for us, especially coming from right from the interior parts of Meghalaya, where road connectivity is not there. For example, they'll have to walk on foot to just carry like a kg of rice, just an example. One is the logistic. Number two is, you know, the absence of a registration office in Northeast. I'll give you an example. Like there was a time when we wanted to certify our agricultural products as organic. But unfortunately, because that organic registration office is not here yet, so it's posing a lot of a challenge for the farmers to actually have to go to, for example, West Bengal, the nearest state to West Bengal. So that can be one. So if we can bring that kind of an office in the Northeast, for the Northeast, I think a lot of some of our challenges would already been, you know, been curbed. And the number three challenges is, you know, as much as we talk about entrepreneurship, entrepreneurial programs, there is still, I will not say an absence, but limited understanding of entrepreneurship amongst the rural communities. So the mindset is still a little thing which we need to tweak furthermore into making it into an entrepreneurial mindset, not necessarily, you know, a free-giving mindset. So these are the three challenges, but I think, yeah, they're possible if we work on them and with them.
Yes, because again, you know, here I would want to add that because we actually do not belong to the business community, and we have, you know, past generations who've been into service, and or possibly, you know, they were just doing their own things and just catering to their own needs. Yes. So definitely we have to develop an entrepreneurial acumen in order to, you know, move forward, learn from the rest of the country about how to do business, how to generate profits, and how to actually, you know, help others grow in the process. So what is your comment? I mean, what would you say about the entrepreneurial scene in the Northeast of India? Because, you know, we have come a long way. We have, in fact, you know, there's been a lot of development in the past few years. So what is your take on that?
So one thing is, I'm very proud of the young entrepreneurs that have come up, you know, into the scene. Every time I click on something on the internet, I would always see one or two young Northeast entrepreneur, can be from any states of the Northeast, you know, doing something with the available resources that we have. So I'm very emotional when I talk about this because I'm very proud of them and that they're doing something, you know, although, yes, there are not that many as yet, but with their inspiring stories, with their inspiring struggles and achievements, a lot of our young people are also following suit. An example of which, one of my nephews is very interested in doing business. Like you said, we're not from a business background, you know, the community, Northeast community as a whole. But he's very interested in doing business, but not so much with, you know, the spices and everything else, but wind, but with wind energy. So these are the things that are changing our young people's mindsets because of entrepreneurs who have tried, tested, failed, and achieved.
Yes, yes. That actually, you know, kind of resonates with what I think about the Northeast, how we are, you know, coming up as entrepreneurs, how this region is actually developing. And what is your message, Mayfereen, to the young entrepreneurs who are aspiring, who are, you know, having these big dreams of, you know, building up an empire? So what's your message to them?
There's only one message I can share with them is that do not believe in fear. Do not believe in stereotypes. Fear, whatever fear that has been imbibed by the society into doing something new, that fear is a liar. So don't believe it. Just believe in yourself and keep striving for what you believe in doing. You will get there one day.
Thank you so much for this lovely message. And I wish you the very best for all your future endeavors and wishing you a very happy International Women's Day. And thanks a lot for joining us today.
Thank you, Dr. Vasai. Wish you the same and all the very best to you too.